welcome back to the channel, guys. Today I'll be taking a look at Cyberpunk 2077 with the AMD RX 7600. Now, this card is pretty new and I'm familiar with its performance, so it should be interesting to me as it might be to some of you guys. So playing at a resolution of 1920 by 1080 in terms of graphics, no ray tracing. I don't believe cards like this really should be trying to use such a heavy setting, in my opinion. You may be able to get away with one or two settings, but I wouldn't recommend using ray tracing, especially with a card like this. But as you can see, I'm using pretty much ultra settings. I'm not using any Psycho for the screen space reflections. That can be quite heavy. And for the crowd density, that's also at high as well. So it should have the maximum amount of NPCs. So I originally bought this GPU as a upgrade for my streaming and recording rig, as it has AV1 encoding capabilities, but it's actually a half decent 1080p GPU as well, and it can get away with some games at 1440p. It actually surprised me in some instances when I put it up against my old RTX 3050, it blew it away pretty much. And there isn't too much of a difference in price between the two cards, so I was pleasantly surprised about that. But yeah, this GPU can give people who want to play Cyberpunk over 60 FPS without ray tracing a decent gaming experience. As you can see, I'm using around 7.7 gigabytes of VRAM, which is very, very close to the VRAM limit. Unfortunately, this card only has 8 gigabytes. It would have been a bit more generous if AMD gave it 12 or 10, but I appreciate that, you know, the price may have had to increase because of that, but who knows what the margins are on these cards. But for sub $300 or £300 in my instance, you do still get a decent amount of gaming performance at 1080p at least. Anyway, I'm going to try and get into my vehicle now and try and do some side missions. So the Phantom Liberty DLC information has been leaked, or not leaked. If you go to GOG now, you can actually potentially pre-order this. So it's going to be around $30, 30 euros. So it's not going to be free. So we'll see how that works out for CD Projekt Red. A lot of people were hoping that they would have given it to us for free just because of how the game launched and all the issues with it, but it seems that they are going to charge us for it, which is understandable because apparently it's the biggest DLC in budget, or how much they've spent on a DLC ever. So they want to recoup some of those costs.
Records himself torturing Joy Toys and sells that shit to like-minded scumbags. The Mox finally tracked him down. This is your chance to give this fucker what he deserves and earn a little scratch while you're at it. More on this sicko attached.
Okay. Let's do it. This is a Tiger Claw. See if his boys run out to try and help him. I'm gonna wait for all the innocent people to get out the way. Don't want to kill any civilians. Get my power shotgun out. Come on, you guys need to leave. Okay, lay that guy down. I love this shotgun. 12 shots. Need to get out of the way of the innocent people. I'm just laying these guys down one by one. I'm just gonna grab all of the loot from the enemies I've killed. Okay, I'm gonna go upstairs now, eliminate the rest of them. Mind taking you guys down from range. Let me just disable this camera. There's one more on this floor somewhere. Tried to pick up the loot as I go along because it's kind of a chore to do it all in one go. Should be more goons waiting for me. I got 12 shots in this thing. Let's take out that turret. Where are you running to? I guess he died from the status damage that's added to this weapon. Nice. Yeah, this guy was obviously making some kind of snuff video or something. Look at all the blood. Absolute psycho. Just having a look around for anything I can take. Always do a little bit of data mining because you can get some easy money. Okay, at least I got one. Sometimes you get like hacking components as well, so always good to do it when you see it. I'm gonna go back and grab all the stuff that I got from these guys. Can't let anything go to waste. I started a brand new game because I just want to do a fresh file to lead into the DLC. Use a shotgun to finish things off. That's what he deserves. Okay, let's see if there's anything else I can grab here. Nothing more I can get. 2 out of 3 is not too bad. think there's a way to exit the building from the roof. What the hell is going on in here? I guess this is the person that they did all the violent acts on. Messed up, man. Anyway, job done. Let's get out of here. This is a bit of a maze, to be honest. Usually there's one or two tiger claws waiting for you at the bottom, but it seems I've eliminated them. Also, it's all clear for once. See what Regina has to say about it. Job done. Should get a call in a few moments.
One less shithead in this city. Cream. Thanks, V. Closing the gig.
Yeah, my street cred's going up pretty quick. Have a quick look at some of the stuff I got. Nothing that I would actually use, so you got two choices. I can break some of these components down or I can sell them. I'll break them down because I'm more into crafting anyway. I did get a little perk up so I can level something up. Let's see now. Deal 25% more damage with rifles and submachine guns to enemies whose health is above 50%. That's actually a good perk. Okay, let's have a look at map, see what else is nearby. So I'm trying to do all the side missions before I kind of continue with the main missions. And it's good to do that because makes all the main missions a lot more comfortable to do. Be a lot stronger. But I've cleaned up as much as I can. The game doesn't really open up until you do most of the missions with Jackie. We all know what happens with Jackie. I'm not going to spoil it for anyone who hasn't played the game. I'll try and do this mission though. I think this one's a fighting mission. Let's call my car. I mean, there's been a one or two stutters in the game, but generally the performance hasn't been too bad. So I'm happy with that so far. So I'm going to be putting out a lot more 1080p content with this card, so for those of you who play at that resolution, I'll try and give you something. I know I play mainly at 4K with my RTX 4090 and 7900 XTX, but I'll be trying to change that in the coming days with a lot more 7600X or 7600 videos. Just going to park up here. There's some kind of NCPD situation going on here, probably gang activity or something. Let's go and check it out. Usually I get a phone call to tell me what I need to do, but no one's calling me. Neutralize any ongoing threat and secure the evidence. It's pretty much what I gotta do, so let's do it. There's Tiger Claw area. Quite a low level, so I need to really watch my health. laid that guy out. I like this gun, it sets you on fire. It's got loads of status elements to it. Let's grab everything these guys put down. Sometimes they drop some good gear, but mainly it's pretty much trash. Let's look for that evidence then. So what were you guys doing? Seems the evidence is below me. Some messages. Tiger Claws pretty much run this town. Another NCPD situation. Go and check it out. Saying the trouble's above me, so we need to get into this building and go upstairs somehow. I think there's an elevator somewhere in here. Can't see any way over there to get up to the top. Guess it's this way. Let's take out all of these goons.
What is with you, fucker?
Come on, show yourself, you coward. Guess they're all burnt to death. Really think I was gonna stand there and let you slice me up with a sword? What's up with this dude? Anyway, let's look for the evidence. These guys are obviously doing some criminal activities up here. So the evidence is pretty clear with this one, not like the other mission. You can get some good stuff, plus you get decent pay from the police as well. Broke as hell when this game first starts, so you kind of got to take everything you can get. Right, let's get out of here. A lot of crime in this little town. So as far as I'm aware, haven't dipped below 60 so far, but there has been a few bits of stuttering here and there, but it's not surprising where you're so dangerously close to the VRAM limit.
Latest recipient, Virginia Granchester, citing her most recent book, In the Shade of an Apple Tree, as a treasure of this generation.
Grandchester. So we just got some gang members there. Created by Raven. They're minding their business, I'll mind mine. For several of her work. I'm gonna check out some of the gear that I got from killing these people. Maybe I got something good. No, all of this is trash. But it's about making money where you can. There is a deposit point over here where you can kind of sell stuff. So I'll do that now. This can go, that can go, that can go, and that can go. That can go as well. You actually make most of your money off clothing, so always sell the clothing that you don't intend to wear or you don't need. Make some good money. Yeah, so I made quite a lot of money there. Maybe I should take a bit of a stutter there. Maybe I should visit a Ripper dock, see what I can upgrade myself to. So I think this is the fight you have to fight the twins, if I correctly remember. Oh man, that was a really, really bad stutter. That was really, really bad. I haven't had any fights yet in this game, so hopefully I do well.
I know where I'm gonna strike before I do it.
For a fight. Which one of you is my guy?
Me!
Wasn't expecting a tag team, but whatever, I guess. So, who do I got first?
No, no. You don't get it. That body and this one, I'm the same person.
So, what? I'm seeing double?
I used to be twins, which you could probably guess. The twins had a close bond. They wanted to be closer, stronger. So they installed neural oscillation sinks. And now they're, well, me.
One person, two bodies.
My bodies do everything together. Everything.
All right, this is fine.
But we're raising the stakes.
Fair. See no problem with that. So? Can we get started?
Show me what you got.
Let's do this. Hopefully I'm good enough to beat these guys. Lay the hands on dude. Man, these guys are chumps.
Stop! Stop! I give up!
Give me my money.
And you? Had enough like your brother, or hungry for more?
That ain't my brother. Oh, that's me. Jesus, what's so hard to understand? Here, your winnings.
Good haul.
Don't worry. There's always the next fight. Stop talking to yourself.
Yeah, I'll leave these guys alone. I'm not interested. But got some good money from that. Coach is happy that I won the first fight. Okay, so that was just a look at Cyberpunk 2077 on the RX 7600. I still think 8GB, even at 1080p for this game, is a little bit lacking. So, spare that in mind. You may have a bit of stuttering here and there. You may want to drop even the texture quality, possibly. But other than that, it does provide you, when not stuttering, over 60 frames per second without ray tracing. So, that is pretty much it for me. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. And as always, thanks for watching.